Oh no, Arnold! Arnold, don't tell me you're gonna drink from this lake! But don't worry, Arnold. If a leech gets into your digestive system, it doesn't have time to harm you. It'll quickly dissolve in your stomach. But you have more than one leech inside you, buddy. You're now the face of the social program, Affordable Housing for Leeches. There are more than 500 types of leeches in the world, but only 3 of them are considered valuable for humans. It would take just 10 minutes for 335 leeches to suck all the blood out of you. And you, Arnold, have 1,000 of them. Every second counts. To get rid of the leeches, you have to drink salt water. Sorry, Arnie, I didn't have another bottle. Drinking water from that lake was a bad idea, Arnold. Even a leech is smart compared to you. Its neurons were used for a biological computer called the Leechulator. It can add prime numbers, and you can't. But don't go rushing to celebrate, Arnold. It seems you've somehow attracted the attention of some really dangerous little dudes. I understand it's hard to believe, but you better not move, buddy. Arnold, let the bees bite you. Bee venom is cool. It contains many beneficial substances that can defeat even fatal diseases. But in your case, you're more likely to die from a heat stroke than from 1,000 bee stings. Bees covering your body will heat it up to 47 degrees Celsius. Ooh, Arnold, you're good. Indeed, electromagnetic waves from a mobile phone can disable a bee. A bee is like a navigation system with a bunch of sensors, pretty much like a tiny little airplane. Apparently then, when flying, just like with big planes, mobile phones must be turned off. In fact, if you put a mobile phone operating at a frequency of 900 megahertz in a beehive, then all the bees will evacuate within 10 minutes and never return. And the winner of the leeches versus bees battle is... no one. It's a draw. Arnold is the winner as the most fearless but stupid person. Bye, Arnold. Hello, Arnold. In front of you is Toxorhynchites, the largest mosquito on the planet, with a wingspan of 12 centimeters. Don't be afraid, dummy. It doesn't need your blood. This species feeds on the nectar of flowers. Be careful, there are ants in here. And what's this? Did you know that mosquito saliva contains enzymes to anesthetize the victim and drink his blood discreetly? But the females don't need the blood for themselves. They feed babies with it. And yes, only females drink blood, and males feed on flower pollen. Better not breathe. A hungry female will smell the CO2 you exhale from 20 meters, and the menthol gum won't help you. They still find you by the heat of your body. But even 1,000 mosquitoes can't suck out all your blood. It'll take 1,100,000 hungry insects. Oh no, Arnold, you disturbed the bullet ant colony. When it bites, a burn is formed on the skin, equal in pain to direct contact with fire. The neurotoxin panerotoxin enters the bloodstream, which attacks the nervous system, paralyzes the limbs, and causes excruciating muscle spasms lasting up to 36 hours. From the bite of 1,000 ants, you'll get so much neurotoxin that you'll experience hallucinations and problems with the supply of oxygen to your organs. But you will survive. In the tribes of South America, in this way, a boy is initiated into a man. Now you're a real man, Arnold. You deserve likes and subscriptions to the channel. Oh, I completely forgot. Mosquitoes carry diseases from sick animals, such as malaria, dengue.
Meet Arnold. Last time we left him in space without a spacesuit, and it seems he doesn't like it here. Let's return him to Earth, or rather, into the ocean. You got lucky here. So, you're inside a sperm whale. But why are you lucky? You slip through the teeth of the sperm whale. Each tooth weighs 2.2 pounds and can crush any and all of your bones. It's quite dark in here. Where does the light come from inside a sperm whale? There's tons of water around you, fish and plankton. The IQ of all these creatures is greater than yours. Now, you have two ways out of here. The sperm whale's throat is only 20 centimeters in diameter, so you are unlikely to get into its stomach without our help. Your story ends here. The hydrochloric acid in the stomach of the sperm whale is so concentrated that you'll suffer multiple chemical burns and painfully die from shock. The second way out is much more doable. Now the sperm whale will start to get rid of excess water, everything inedible, and if you're lucky, you too. Whales swim at a depth of 200 meters, but such an unprepared little wimp like you could only escape at a maximum depth of 20 meters without equipment. But what's this? Do you smell smoke? Where does smoke inside a sperm whale come from? Arnold, do you feel like a real boy? Okay, but you certainly won't drown in the water.
Piranhas!
There are about 50 different kinds of piranha, of which only a few eat the flesh of living beings. All other species are either vegetarians or eat only carrion.
Arnie, guess what piranhas you're gonna meet?
My smart boy, you're right! Fortunately for Arnie, and to the disappointment of our viewers, in science there has never been recorded even a single case of piranhas attacking and killing a person.
Well then, we're gonna have to create such a case. Arnie, jump in!
As you can see, you're absolutely uninteresting to them. And what's more, they're even afraid of you. Aggressiveness in piranhas depends on several factors. The first is heat. Add temperature, please. Thank you. This hell will drive anyone crazy. During a drought, the water level in the river drops and finding food becomes much more difficult. This leads to a second huge factor, hunger. Starving piranhas are ready to eat even their sick, weak relatives. And where does that leave you, Arnie? The third factor that affects their aggressiveness is the need to protect their brood. Mom and dad don't like it when their kids are disturbed. Add a small bloody cut as an appetizer, and you, Arnie, are ready to meet the piranhas. The structure of their jaws allows them to tear out large chunks of meat from their prey. Razor-sharp teeth, 4 to 5 millimeters long, can bite through tendons and even small bones. Arnie, you can forget about your fingers and toes. In just a few minutes, you'll have a perfectly clean skeleton. One of the largest representatives of piranhas weighs up to 1 kilogram. But how big should the jaws be so that they can eat Arnold, including all of his bones? Let's increase the size of the piranha teeth by 6 times. Such teeth can easily cut the bones into tiny little fragments. Piranhas are the janitors of the rivers, Arnie. They leave absolutely nothing to rot at the bottom of the Amazon. Well, that is, except for hair. Even fish think your hair is stupid, Arnie.
Hello, Arnold. Did you sell your bath? Why? What? Is it all about the new PS5? You know, Arnie, one Dr. James Hamlin has shown it's possible not to wash for over 5 years. Let's do a challenge. The surface of our skin is home to a huge number of bacteria that form what's called the microbiome. It's understood that if you avoid using soap over an extended period of time, your microbiome balance will naturally stabilize. However, if you don't wash for even 3 days, you'll start to itch. Don't worry. Go get some air. Clearly, after a few days without a shower, you've started to stink something awful. Okay, not such a bad idea to buy a bunch of deodorant. The global trend of using fragrances to mask the body's smell first appeared in medieval Europe. At that time, people bathed on average only 2 times in their entire life, at birth and at death. Yes, the evil odor is gone, but frequent use of deodorants can cause allergies and shortness of breath, and the aluminum salts they use can even lead to the growth of cancer cells. Even in our time, in our modern world, there are still people who wash themselves very rarely. In addition to the homeless, there are the residents of the far north, the Eskimos and the Chukchi. Are you feeling like a pile of garbage, Arnold? Permanent non-washing can lead you to a loss of self-esteem, and the kids next door would paint your house with graffiti and tease you about your stankiness. Where are you going, Arnold?
Oh, I really hope you don't do anything stupid.
Arnold, there you are! You've decided to move in with the Chukchi. Congratulations! Moreover, the challenge is finished. Your skin has become soft, fresh, and your acne has completely disappeared. But wait, what's that? It looks like today the Chukchi are celebrating a holiday with ritual bathing. First, they put on all the clothes they have and try to sweat as much as possible. Then they scrape each other's skin clean with bone scrapers. And after all that, they grease themselves up with seal fat. Arnold, you're now about to be bathed in the best traditions of the far north. And you certainly can't run very far. They'll find you by your smell.
Ooh, Arnold, looks like someone had some fun last night.
And something tells me your brain is probably just as much of a mess as this room. You really don't remember anything at all. Arnold, could it really be? Last night, did you finally become a real man? Congratulations, Arnold. This is your first alcohol intoxication. And these are the first unpleasant consequences of a new acquaintance. Arnold, how about a toast to your new friend? Ah, well, I see. Of course, if you gotta, you gotta. Oh, Arnold, did you really want to make a lifelong reminder of this event? At least you'll have something to tell your friends about later. As you can see, the consequences of alcohol intoxication don't just damage your health, they damage your bank account too. Oh, you were unmatched in generosity last night, Arnold. You were the king of the party. Now where's your tooth? Anything ring a bell? Nothing? No? Arnold, you didn't know this, but drinking too much leads to unnecessary aggression. And you certainly paid a price for that. Ooh, you found a solution. Time to take aspirin. Oh, wait, no. You forgot to restock your first aid kit. But really, Arnold, all these troubles are just in your head. Mineral water is a miraculous thing. You're dehydrated. Just need to replenish the missing water from your body. What's with the jacuzzi? I totally understand if you want to quit drinking after last night, but not water. You didn't think it'd be that easy to escape your hangover, did you?
Someone call Spielberg. We have a plot for a new Jaws.
What is it, Arnold? Are you calling an ambulance? Ah, you decided to recharge your strength with delicious pizza. But you forgot about one thing. Booze breath. These are the decay products of ethanol that appear in the body after the liver has taken over its processing. One of them, acetic acid, has a particularly nasty smell. Hey, Arnold, you sure you still want to sleep after eating? Sadly, you can forget about sleep. Cerebellar functions are impaired after alcohol intake. As soon as you close your eyes, the cerebellum ceases to have enough data for orientation in space and starts transmitting broken data to the cerebral cortex. Say hello to bed spins. Poor Arnold. It's a pity just to look at you. Let me give you one piece of advice. Right now, a cup of hot tea will save you. Wrap yourself in a warm blanket and fall asleep so soundly that no prince can possibly wake you up with his kiss. Arnold, I told you it would help. Well, I congratulate you on your second birthday. Don't forget, Arnold, behind every mask of joy lies some seriously nasty things. Come on, you did this one to yourself. See you next time, Arnold, when we hope you'll finally have your head screwed on right. Sorry, but you can't escape. Even at an altitude of 5,000 meters, you still have to work on your YouTube channel. Where are you flying to? At least check the map. Ooh, looks like you flew right into the Bermuda Triangle. According to rumors, planes and ships often disappear here. Arnold, where did your jet wings and clothes go? Seems like the rumors are true and you're about to disappear.
Science doesn't recognize the strange things taking place in the Bermuda Triangle. However, there are several non-scientific theories. According to one of them, everything that disappears here ends up in a parallel universe. Look, everything's a little different here. You look strange even to this dog. As you can see, your house has also changed a lot. I advise you to be careful there. Meet Arnold. This is Arnold, although from a parallel universe. He's much more successful than you, and even sports a stylish mustache. And it looks like he doesn't like you at all. At the bottom of the Bermuda Triangle is the mythical city of Atlantis. Don't ask, because I have no idea why the ancient Atlanteans needed all these planes and ships. But ancient customs and traditions are harsh. Someone like you will be immediately turned into a slave. Or if you can't handle it, you'll be turned into fuel for steamboats. Careful, Arnold, new vehicles are arriving. There is another theory. Everything that happens in the Bermuda Triangle is due to aliens. And perhaps they're taking vehicles to study human technology or putting it in a museum. Just look at how much stuff they have in their exhibits. Since aliens are poorly versed in terrestrial life forms, you were placed with mushrooms. Don't be offended, Arnold. It could be because of your haircut. You won't be bored for long. They say aliens abduct people for a different purpose. You must get pregnant and carry their alien baby. Sorry, Arnold, but aliens are also bad at gender. Did you finally wake up? It seems that at this altitude, you passed out from a lack of oxygen and had some crazy dreams. And this blackbird mistook you for a rival. As I said, from a scientific point of view, nothing unusual happens in the Bermuda Triangle. Calm down, Arnold. No planes, ships, or people disappear here. Provided, of course, that their jet wings don't run out of fuel. Hey, everyone. I think you all know this redhead pretty well. Come on, finish your burrito and let's go to the garage. I'll show you my new device for shrinking people. Aw, you dropped your burrito. Arnold, are you seriously going to eat that? Okay, the 5-second rule says you can eat dropped food if it doesn't stay on the floor longer than 5 seconds. But I wouldn't. Arnold, what's wrong with you? Does your tummy ache? This is the perfect chance to test my quantum resizer and find out from the inside what's hurting you. Put this helmet on and I'll connect your consciousness to your nano copy and insert you into your own body. But first take off your underpants. It's the fastest way to get you to your destination. Here we go! You ate a burrito which contained the eggs of some very smart tapeworms. Arnold, just look at this. They built a whole metropolis inside of you. They even built a zoo. Let's check out the zoo. Today's Monday, so there's a 50% discount. My God, this is a zoo of pathogenic viruses and bacteria. I admire your interlopers. Spanish flu, plague, Ebola, tuberculosis, swine and bird flu, and a bunch of other rare pathogens all in one place. Look, there's even my favorite, the little studied Barona virus, also known as sad horse disease. It mainly affects horses, cows, rabbits, and other animals. Arnold, I wouldn't put my fingers in the cage if I were you. It's suspected that the infection causes schizophrenia. Arnold, unfortunately, your stomach hurts due to parasites. Look, they're building a highway in your intestines, a water park in your bladder. If they build a data center in your head, you'll most likely kick the bucket because your head is so small. You need to figure out how to expel them from your body. The sooner, the better. If you open all the cells of this Pandora zoo, most likely it'll help you expel the worms. Come on, Arnold, go ahead. It's better to cough from a couple of days of Ebola than live with these worms inside of you. Congratulations, Arnold, on the heroic exile of the parasites. I hope your immune system can cope with such a menagerie of diseases. This played for a little too long today, Arnie. The only sensible solution is to go to bed. Good night, Arnold. Spending the whole day playing video games won't go unnoticed. After such excitement, something terrible can happen. For example, sleep paralysis. REM sleep is a state in which the body is immobilized. With sleep paralysis, your brain wakes up, but your muscles stay frozen. So you can see and hear, but you can't move. During these moments, hallucinations start to occur, and it feels like a demon is sitting on you. But this isn't for long. What's wrong, Arnie? Are you afraid to sleep in the dark? About 10% of people on Earth suffer from nyctophobia, the fear of darkness. Scientists believe that this trait is genetically inherited. Our ancestors were afraid of being eaten by nocturnal predators, and so our imagination paints the most terrible pictures in the dark. Ooh, it looks like there's someone behind that window. Ha! In the world ranking of candy-ass scaredy pants, you, Arnold, get first place. All fear is formed in the amygdala of the brain. A feeling of fear is formed in this little tiny 1.5 centimeter sac. There were actual cases when people's amygdala was destroyed due to a disease called Urbach-White. This permanently disables the fear response. But this most definitely doesn't apply to you, Arnold. You're afraid of everything, even your own shadow. Okay, I'll turn on the light, just so you know that nobody's here. But sleeping with the lights on is a bad idea, too. It suppresses the amount of melatonin produced during sleep, which can lead to excess weight. Therefore, the choice is obvious. In order not to become an overweight, yellow-bellied poltroon, you need to sleep in the dark. Yeah, falling asleep when it feels like someone else is in the room is not an easy task. Maybe it's just your imagination. Or maybe not.
Arnold! Wake up! I have a surprise for you. Of course, you know I'm your ally in battling your social phobia. I've decided to help you by moving you further away from people, specifically to the top of Mount Everest. The mountain's other name is Chomolungma, and it's the highest point on planet Earth. By the way, just saying, but you owe me $50,000. This is the average price for an expedition up here. To survive at the top, you need top-level equipment. After all, there's very little oxygen, and it's extremely cold. Go down, quickly, at least a kilometer. Hurry up, Arnold, but move as slowly as possible. Oxygen is only 1/3 the normal here. Try to save your energy. Lack of air causes the brain to misperceive time. Crawling 5 meters in 3 hours sounds a little too slow to me. Fortunately, the wind at the top reaches 200 meters per second, and it can help us. You can fly 8 kilometers in just 3 minutes. But be careful, the ledges may get in your way. Lucky you, you fell into the trash. Everest tourists leave so much garbage on the mountain that the government pays $2 for every kilogram of garbage collected. I see you're trying to pay me my $50,000 back. Arnold, try not to breathe so much. At a temperature of minus 60 degrees Celsius, your lungs will begin to dry out. Mountain coughs are so bad they can even break your ribs. I'm sorry, Arnold, but climbers can't remove corpses from Mount Everest. It's impossible. Moreover, corpses are used as height markers for mountain peaks. Well, Arnold, at least you found something useful to do. I see you're really happy to be here, buddy, especially after such fiercely cold conditions. I think perhaps you're enjoying it a little too much. Hello, Arnold. It looks like you started hallucinating from a lack of oxygen, and someone brought you to the campfire. I'm glad that you woke up, but there are still 6 kilometers ahead of us.
Unfortunately, I don't think you have the strength left to reach home. But wait, Arnold, I have an idea. You can repeat the feat of Marco Siffredi. In 2001, he descended Mount Everest on a snowboard. I believe in you, Arnold. Multiple broken bones and the last stages of frostbite. But we reached the Earth! Arnold, it's unbelievable! Come on, shout with me. Hooray! Arnold, I was just kidding. You can't scream in the mountains. It can trigger an avalanche. Don't worry, Arnold. I'm not going to leave you here. You still owe me $50,000.
Hey, Arnie,
where'd you go?
Get ready, Arnold. A new experiment awaits you. A bathtub full of boiling hot water. Stop watching Netflix and stop texting Susie. She's not going to answer you anyway.
Come on. No way. Are you finally going to meet her?
What a maroon.
You're seriously depressed, buddy. The World Health Organization estimates that depression affects 300 million people worldwide. That's about 4% of the global population. Depression occurs due to a deficit of neurotransmitters in the brain, serotonin, norepinephrine, and dopamine. Without these natural chemicals, favorite activities stop being pleasurable and colors turn gray. And all of this can end very tragically. So just don't do something stupid, Arnie. Arnold, you have millions of fans on YouTube. Why do you need all this? Come to me, buddy. I'll give you a big hug. Depression isn't just a change in mood. It's a real illness. To treat it, you most definitely need to consult a doctor, preferably a psychiatrist. Antidepressants can help you, but be careful. Some are addictive. Start going to the gym. Believe it or not, exercise is one of the best ways to reduce symptoms of depression. And change your diet. Eat more dark chocolate, seafood, nuts, and fruits. Meet with your friends. You can get a pet and take it for walks in the park. Now that everything's stabilized in your nervous system and your hormones of happiness have returned to normal levels, the world sparkles with new colors. And now that you're in better physical shape, girls have even started checking you out, buddy. Is that Susie? She's ready to meet you. Quick, answer her and tell her you're just standing here like an ignoramus.
Oh, no. Not again.
Please help my poor buddy Arnold. You can give him some likes. For Arnie, it's the best cure for what ails him. I can't watch this.
Hello, Arnold. Hey, I see the late night beer bash is a big success. But don't forget, in the morning, you got a conference of below 60 IQ YouTubers. And if you're late, your career is toast. There's no time for the toilet. You gotta hold it, buddy. The bladder comfortably holds 150 to 200 milliliters of fluid, but after 400 to 500 milliliters, you'll feel some pressure. You must have drunk a lot. Looks like the boss is in a bad mood, and for sure he ain't gonna let anyone take bathroom breaks. Fluid is absorbed into the kidneys, then descends through the ureter into the bladder. You're probably feeling a bit stressed, Arnold, because now you gotta hold the pee in with your muscles. I recommend you don't laugh, Arnold, or sneeze, or cough. Anything like that weakens the muscles, and you might start leaking. Hooray! Break time! You're saved! The average person goes tinkle 6 to 8 times a day. Ooh, no luck there, Arnold. In ancient times, rules of decency allowed people to go wee-wee in public, and the division of toilets into men's and ladies' only occurred in 1792. Okay, break's over, buddy. Now it's your turn to give your presentation. If you hold it in for a long time, the bladder walls can stretch, so you can hold even more pee-pee. But this can be dangerous. Bacteria and acids in your urine can crawl back up into your kidneys, causing cystitis and pyelonephritis. It seems, Arnold, that everyone approves of your dissatisfaction with company policy. Come on, Arnold. I know you can hold it a little longer. Just 50 more talks and then you're free. Well, that's it. Time to go home. And Arnold,
I advise you not to make any sudden movements. If your bladder is that full, it could pop. Yay, you're almost home. Now we just have to get through the morning rush hour. Move slowly. Oh no, it seems your neighbor's coming, Arnold. You know, the guy who likes to give everyone a big hug when they meet. Ooh, that's not good.